years ago. And since then, I've actually spent all of my time, instead of doing art, I've been a stay-at-home mom. Mm-hmm. So I just recently started painting again in the past year. And I actually have a studio and trying to get a gallery up and going here in Austin as well.
That's great. So yeah, it's nice that you're an artist and now also a gallery owner. So first of all, I want to hear more about your art. We've got a couple of your pieces here. Tell me a little bit about it. I know you're into surrealism and just displaying the outer, your personal outer existence versus your personal inner existence. So tell me about it.
Yes, that's pretty much exactly. I work a lot from, I'm a pretty introverted person, so mm-hmm. I'll say that first. And so I'm always in my head, and a lot of the stuff that does come out on the canvas is emotional things mm-hmm. Or very personal thoughts. Put out, you know, for display in some ways that maybe aren't quite so obvious to the viewer. So this particular painting came about from moving in with my now husband before we got married. We moved in together, and there was a bit of turmoil and some different things going on in our lives, and the particular place where we moved to had been previously occupied by him and his ex-wife. So yeah, and she was actually a painter too. So these splattery paints represent her and covering up the past, and then also the curtains are representative of trying to make a new home and, you know, make your own fit into the environment in your own style and with your own, you know, things that we do to make a home our own. And then the spider down here is
6'4". Yeah, that's interesting imagery that you've connected to your personal experience. This is a very personal painting, you know.
It's super personal.
It's great to hear your